Hey, it's Shantae Brown Sugar talking to Black Unicorns. Coming to you today with the show. With the show. I'm still getting ready on the line. I'm still getting ready on the line. So today, y'all, I done woke up and did my pancetta and brie with pancetta brie with apricot. It is so good. Apricot preserves. And vegan tortilla chips. I can't even talk, it's so good. I usually just have coffee for breakfast. It's so good. It is so effing delicioso. Es delicioso. Good. Good. Let me see. Delicious in German. Cause y'all. Why they put it in Japanese? I did not say Japanese. I don't even know how to pronounce it. I don't understand Japanese writing. Koshlik. I keep not hooking up my microphone, so the sound on the show might be awful. For Facebook and YouTube. Koshlik. It's so costly. Hi, I'm Shantae Schuler, and I am from Brown Sugar Talk and Black Unicorns. Hello. Okay, y'all, I'm sorry for just clicking and not talking. All right, that's it. This is the last one. Last button. So, what this stuff reminded me of is when me and Blake first got to Texas, Kevin Fry came and took us out and all this different stuff, right? So, when he did all that, he was so nice to us. We didn't know he was abusive. So, I am stuck in a world of abusive people. I'm masturbating again today, and the person is like saying stuff while I'm masturbating. It's not that we hear voices or anything like that. Somebody is actually talking while I'm masturbating. Like they can see what is inside this room. That's the same thing that happened at the hotel room. If people are telling you this, they are not crazy. Nothing is wrong with them. They don't need to go to the psych ward. None of that. they are being sex trafficked. And so this person will try to, this is what she did when she was at this school. She didn't tell us that this was her. First off, it wasn't your business. If something came to you with my name on it, why do I have to turn around and try to prove to somebody that this is me? Even with my auntie asking me, don't you sew? Can't you hem these pants? All this different stuff. Even with her asking me all that stuff, it's the same fucking thing. I don't have to prove to her or anybody else who I am. It's like, if that's who I am, that's just who I am. If I say that, then why therefore go through my home? Why therefore, y'all, did y'all see the video when I was doing the grazing table? And the camera moved like it panned. This camera on the Chromebook does not pan. Y'all understand what I'm saying? So this person has this excuse like they supposed to be watching me and you not. Their experimentation is over. It's not something for you to watch me, and that wasn't for you to do anyway. It was for me to do. So it's like, that's why I was saying there are no excuses. None whatsoever for you to watch me masturbate. For you to try to watch me in the shower. For you to not have me with my son. There are no excuses. If you did that many wrong things, wouldn't you be the person trying to murder me too? If you know you wrong, every day you trying to act like you not wrong. If you know you wrong, wouldn't you be the person trying to murder me too? Because you already desperate. Wouldn't you be the person stalking me too? So on this thing, after they do all that, watching me masturbate, all this different stuff, the person will try to like act like they gonna try to, they fussing at somebody. It's every time. Like they really trying to like stop the person. But then tomorrow if I masturbate, they gonna be watching tomorrow too. So the same person that's looking at the Smiths and telling them what they heard in my apartment, when I say this, Will Smith, are the same people that killed Kobe Bryant. They the same people that was down there in Texas at that fucking hotel trying to act like it was something else going on, trying to act like I wasn't qualified for whatever jobs. But you using my resume. Look, somebody said, somebody sitting there looking stupid and all this different stuff. That stuff ain't, it's inexcusable. Leave me alone. Give me my sons so I can take care of them and move on with my fucking life. Ain't none of this for y'all to do. You made up something, now you want me to live in it. No, that's not how that life works. Russell, they talk about Russell. Let me tell y'all. They'll use what I say about somebody else and try to get somebody else there. So when I was doing booty yoga, it was a white woman that was in a yoga class. And I guess she wanted to get with Russell Simmons. Y'all see what I'm saying? Because they had seen his show. And like, Russell got a type. So I'm the person they talking about. Y'all understand what I'm saying? I'm the person that said all the stuff about Boosie. All this year. Just because I look like this today don't mean I look like that yesterday. Y'all won't. y'all want a glamorous life and you don't have, you want a glamorous life but you don't have the ways to get there. Y'all don't want to work. You want to kill people and then sit in a position like you want to sit in this chair and act like now because you got to weave down your back, a nice bra on, and some cute panties that somebody's supposed to help you and give you everything. And by all means, they might, but you don't have to kill anybody else to get there. Me being alive or existing does not do anything for you. Me having a small waist, a little ass, whatever, it don't do anything for you. And so it's like, why would I be your target if you really just want to get somewhere and get some money? Last night I thought about that. I was like, it's because y'all got to be gay. Like, your sexual orientation is not defined. And so it's like, instead of y'all just really focusing on trying to figure out your own sexual orientation, because these have become sex crimes. This has went from somebody being jealous of me in my classroom to then wanting to know how me and my baby daddy have sex. Y'all understand what I'm saying? I'm an educational person. Everything I'm doing is part of education. So then a person that's the superintendent over the school is worried about me and my baby daddy having sex. The principal is worried about if I look sexy for another man in my classroom. And I'm only there to teach. If I work out and I buy a certain outfit, all I'm thinking about is how good I feel and look in the outfit because I was in an abusive relationship. I was overweight. And I didn't have an excuse for it. I was working out like every day. This man was putting something in my food. I was trying to get away from abuse. So for me to get to the school, or even I got the job at Ann Taylor and start just like kind of take care of myself, because when I was at Central Market, y'all, I didn't even know I had got that small. I tell y'all a story. That man came and was like, hey, it's a bonus. You know what I'm saying? You probably need to get some clothes. Y'all, I did not know my clothes had gotten that big. The pants I had on were a size 10 when he came to me. And it was already looping around. I got down to a size 6, 8. More on a 6 side. I was still 180 pounds. I couldn't break 180. I was so obsessed with working out. I would work out 3 times a day. I would go in the morning as soon as I get up. Come back, get ready for work. Y'all see what I'm saying? My whole day was busy. And I still wasn't making enough money to make ends meet. I wasn't working my money the way I needed to. Then I would wait. When I get off work, I go to the gym and do a quick workout then. And when I got off from that job, before I go home, I go do another workout. The whole time I'm thinking about eating 6 times a day. I'm thinking about every meal, portion control, portion size. That's why now I can control portion. Like, you know, portion, that's like not even an issue for me. And so I guess because I was such a neurotic person, somebody might think that that was something where I was like trying to reach perfection. No, I was trying to get the abuse out of my head. And a lady told me I was addicted to it. And it was the truth. I was addicted to working out because I was addicted to losing weight. I was addicted to the numbers. You see what I'm saying? I never broke 180. One day, I went to go try on some clothes at, that's when I started buying more expensive clothes. So I started at Banana Republic. I went to go try on some clothes at Banana Republic. And I put the dress on and it was too big. It was a size 8. I just stood there and started crying. I got so small. I went on drugs or nothing, y'all. I just made sure I watched my diet. And I took a lot of vitamins. And that wasn't healthy either, because that's when my hair started coming out. As fine as I was balding. So I'm balding because really I did have thalassemia. And I wasn't getting any iron. I had like low iron. and I wasn't getting all my nutrients from my food, because really the most protein-packed thing I ate was a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, and I would eat half of that for dinner. Y'all understand, I would probably eat the rest of it the next day. I'm talking about I had portion control down to a T. And it's like, it's not something that is feasible. It's not something that is normal. That's why when I look at Shamika Samuels, I'm like, you just the old version of me. You see what I'm saying? That's how I know. I never bother people like that, though. The whole time, I never bothered not one person. You know why? Because the focus was on myself. I really did get to know myself. So when I got angry at myself. If you looking at my video, Shamika Samuels, because you got an SS, you know what I'm saying? You ain't never wrote the letter. It wasn't you that was being abused. You see what I'm saying? I went to that point because of abuse. At no point have y'all ever looked and thought that that was abusive. But you thought my clothes were so cute, and you thought that my house was so put together, and you thought all this different stuff. And it's all because of perfectionism. It's all because I thought that because these people were stalking me, it was a reason, because I was too perfect, or because I was this and the other. I didn't know why they were stalking me. These men set out to stalk me in college. They set out to stalk me in college. This is a plan they made up in college after they stole my journal. After the song was written, was sung by Erykah Badu that I wrote. These men plan to actually try to put me in pornos and all this shit in college. Not one time had I presented myself as a hoe. I'm talking about I had a boyfriend for 3 years of college. Actually, four, because I started with the football player. After that, after he broke up with me, I had another boyfriend. Y'all see what I'm saying? And the only time it stopped being a boyfriend is because they would start the rumors of something I was doing. Y'all didn't put the shit in books. You didn't put it on TV and music and every fucking. These motherfuckers set out to actually murder me in college. I'm blessed. They still stealing. They stole the whole rape story and made a song for my cousin Beyonce. It feels so good to be alive. Could wipe this black off if I try. And then gave it to Serena Daddy like he was, like that was him. I ain't never seen nobody so sexually involved in something come to terms with what you doing, because that is beyond normal sexuality. If I'm in here masturbating and I can hear somebody talking and telling me what they could do, and ooh, she fucking this person and bringing up Wallow and Kevin Gates and whoever else the fuck they talking about, I'm not fucking them, and I ain't trying to fuck them either. Just because it's a man crush money don't mean we fucking. Y'all do stuff that's over the boundary of friendship. If you actually listening to me in this room, in my space, in my show, you know that I do friendships. I ain't fucking know every motherfucker I see. My mind is not working towards fucking every nigga I see. I don't want no bitch to eat my pussy. This be the shit they be saying. I just keep masturbating and just try to focus on my own thoughts so I can get this shit out of my fuck, so they can get the fuck out of my life. This your world. You trying to watch me like I'm a part of it. I'm not a part of your world. And that's the shit that be pissing me off. This is the shit y'all don't understand. Every motherfucker can't be your fucking woman. If you want a porn star, look at a porno. Y'all understand what I'm saying? Because that woman, that's something that she enjoy. Polyamory and all that shit. She can have a husband, go fuck a man on set, then go back home and fuck her husband. I'm just not that girl. Every woman you meet is not there to be a hoe. If your girl sitting there telling you she with you, she probably just with you. Every woman ain't like a fucking dog ass polyamorous man either. You see what I'm saying? Because then another man, he'll look at you and be thinking, well, you like that. Because he like that. He can fuck his girl, go fuck another girl, then come back and fuck his girl again. Every person don't want two or three dicks in them. Every nigga don't want five or six pussies. Y'all understand? It's like y'all are nasty people. And y'all be wanting somebody else to come and be nasty with you. If you polyamorous, I'm not talking about you. Because usually they focus on they self. You see what I'm saying? A real person in a polyamorous relationship be focused on they self. You see what I'm saying? When they focus on they self, they focus on their lover. They ain't trying to find somebody and then we gonna stalk her and we gonna see what she doing and then we gonna be polyamorous with her. Even though she don't want to. If you try to force me to listen to you, fuck your bitch and tell her she can put her face in my pussy. It's not working. Because I'm not that type of woman. That's why I kill you. Don't try to come after me because I ain't never came after you. Get the fuck out of my fucking life. I want my child. I want a relationship. I don't give a fuck about what these niggas think they wanted or nothing, nigga. Get the fuck out my face. If it ain't privilege, it's privilege because it sounds like it's a fucking black man. I ain't no hoe. I be so pissed, y'all. I'll kill you. Okay, here we go. 20 phrases that will make your donor feel like a hero. That's it. Like, today is all about donations. It's just about giving and receiving. I could go over this shit with you. I'm finna get off this shit, man. That shit be pissing me the fuck off. I will slowly fucking kill your ass. I'll fucking carve you like a fucking turkey. Y'all, I put a motherfucker in the oven. Like, they be thinking I'm fucking playing. Don't no person want you like that. I don't want to be involved in nobody else's relationship. I don't want a threesome with you and your woman. I don't want to hear about you and your woman having no fucking threesome. If it's a porno, then they putting a porno out there for you to watch it. I watch porn myself. That means that person wants to be involved. They loaded the picture up. You see what I'm saying? They put theyself out there. I'm in the privacy of this fucking room. You over here trying to watch me like I'm a porno. Y'all see what I'm saying? Ain't no fucking reason for no motherfucker to do that shit. Please leave me alone. It's sex trafficking. And y'all can keep saying that this person be like, well, they ain't doing nothing to you. Yes, they are. It's still sex trafficking. If I'm telling you, if you in my space and I didn't invite you in here, if you not supposed to be here with no camera, then that's sex trafficking. It's still sex trafficking. You still got to go to jail. You still doing something to somebody. I'm talking about this came from education into some whole slut type shit. Because y'all bitches some fucking education sluts. I'm talking about these are teachers. I'm going to fuck him for my kid's school clothes. For school start. Nah, bitch, you just going to fuck him. You see what I'm saying? I'm not that type of bitch. Have a good day. Blake, thank you and I love you.